This video is a review of the trigonometry of right and oblique triangles. These properties are important for later applications in engineering. Let's look at an example of a right triangle with an angle of interest theta. The hypotenuse C is the longest side of a right triangle and is always the side that is opposite to the right angle of the right triangle. The first set of trigonometry functions to be demonstrated are sine and cosecant. The sine function is the ratio of the length over the side opposite of the angle of interest B, over the hypotenuse. The cosecant function is the reciprocal of the sine function. This means that the cosecant is equal to 1 divided by the sine function. The second set of functions is the cosine function and its reciprocal, the secant function. Like the sine function, the cosine function is a ratio of lengths. It is a ratio of the length adjacent to the angle of interest A over the hypotenuse, rather than the length opposite. The last set of functions shown are the tangent function and its reciprocal, the cotangent function. The tangent function is the ratio of the length opposite the angle of interest B over the length adjacent to the angle of interest A. Another key property of right triangles is the Pythagorean theorem. The length adjacent squared plus the length opposite squared is equal to the hypotenuse squared. The 7 properties discussed are the most common trigonometry properties used. In order to demonstrate the application of some of these functions, let's do an example problem. Given a right triangle with a hypotenuse of 104.67 feet, and an angle theta of 32 degrees, 13 minutes, and 42 seconds, what is the opposite side length, the adjacent side length, and the remaining angle of this triangle? First, the opposite side length will be solved using the sine function. This is because 2 of the 3 variables are known. Manipulate the sine function to solve for the opposite side lengths. Insert the given information to get a result of 55.82 feet. Next, using the same process as before, find the adjacent side length. However, instead of the sine function, use the cosine function to find the adjacent side. The adjacent side length of this triangle is 88.54 feet. Lastly, solve for the remaining angle of the triangle. Because this is a right triangle, 2 angles are already known: 90 degrees, the right angle, and theta, the angle given. Also, it is a known property that the interior angles of a triangle must add up to 180 degrees. In this example, the lowercase Greek letter alpha is used to symbolize the remaining angle. To find the remaining angle, subtract the known angles from 180 degrees. The remaining angle of this triangle is 57 degrees, 46 minutes, and 18 seconds. Oblique triangles are triangles that do not have an angle equal to 90 degrees. This means that the basic trigonometric functions do not apply. The law of sines and the law of cosines can be used for oblique triangles. The law of sines in combination with the law of cosines allows for the calculation of all unknown angles or sides as long as there are 3 knowns. These knowns need to include at least 1 angle and 1 side length. Displayed is a list of all the permutations of the law of cosines to solve for any side length. The second example problem will demonstrate the use of the law of cosines and the law of sines in oblique triangle problems. Given a triangle with a side 212 feet long that is between angles of 42 degrees and 74 degrees, what are the 2 remaining side lengths and what is the remaining angle? Using the knowledge from the first example problem, the third angle can be found by subtracting the 2 known angles from 180 degrees. In this example, the third angle or remaining angle is labeled as theta. Theta can be found to be 64 degrees. The 2 remaining side lengths will be found both with the law of sines and law of cosines. Both the law of sines and law of cosines equations have 4 variables. The law of sines has 2 angles and 2 lengths. The law of cosines has 3 lengths and 1 angle. Choose the best fit equation for the information given. Manipulate the law of sines equation to solve for the unknown side B. Insert the known and previously calculated information to return a result of 157.83 feet. Next, use the law of cosines to find the last unknown side. Insert all of the necessary information into the equation. Then solve for side A. The resulting side length of side A is 226.73 feet.